Good morning, American Jiu-Jitsu. We are at fourth degree, tape 9. Never thought I would get this high in the sense of making these videos. I hope you're all staying home healthy and safe. Remember to tag American Jiu-Jitsu LI. It's our YouTube page. Please like and subscribe to it. It's our Facebook group page. It's also our email, AmericanJiu-JitsuLI@gmail.com. AJJ Centers is our website that will give you all the information on our Zoom classes and our virtual training, which is 6 days a week. We do post videos 5 days a week, Monday through Friday. Those are instructional, and the full library is on the YouTube page, American Jiu-Jitsu LI, or the Facebook group page. These tapes, like I've said, are more review tapes for my students than they are training tapes. And what I mean by that is I don't go into specific detail about how the technique is being done. So therefore, you can watch these tapes and you can make a lot of assumptions and assume things, but these are junior level, master level techniques that is very easily misunderstood if you don't know what you're watching. What I ask you to do, especially in these times when it's so chaotic out there, if you're really interested in what we're doing, make some notes, email me at American Jiu-Jitsu LI, ask me some questions, and more importantly, hopefully when we reopen, come down to the dojo. This is not a time to be negative or not have good comments because, you know, there's too much of that out there today. So if you don't like it, just kind of hit delete, you know, or stop. And if you do like it, which we hope you do, remember, American Jiu-Jitsu is not a grappling art. American Jiu-Jitsu is what they call a combative art. It's a self-defense art for all street situations. We do cover a lot of gun because we do teach a lot of law enforcement. First video that we're gonna make today is on a situation where a person is grabbing you and has a knife or a gun. So now what happens is it interrupts the flow of your basic gun technique. This was a question that was brought to me by law enforcement, so we put it on our curriculum. All right, so the first one's gonna be a leverage hand with a knife attack where they might be pulling you and try to drive that knife, and the same thing with the gun. The reality is, without getting too technical, well, when a person grabs you with a knife, they're gonna look to pull you in and strike. And when a person has a gun, they're gonna try to keep you away and use that because they have a projectile. The knife, they need to get close to you. With a gun, they kind of keep you away. So typically the studies have shown that when they go to grab you with, they have a knife. When they go to kind of put the hand there, it's when they have a gun because they don't need to grab you, all right? And they don't wanna lose control of that gun. So that's how these techniques are addressed. We call this leverage arm against gun and knife. And we have a couple of different variations depending on a couple of different situations. Again, if you're not sure about what you're watching, write some notes, email me, call me, come down when the dojo opens up. It looks like we're gonna be opening up around July 15th, so we're hoping for that. We have the studio well prepared, we're ready to go. We're just waiting for you and our governor. All right, so let's do the first one, leverage hand against the knife. This is when the person is approaching you, they actually don't get the grab on, and we're gonna avoid the hand that's going to grab, and we're gonna put them in a technique that we call here Harigatami, which is extending the arm and the person's neck. So let's look at that. Boom, and back. That's beautiful. Let's look at that. Remember, the knife is in the back hand. That's where the control is. So from here, he's avoiding the knife from here, getting behind her, and if need be, he could snap and crack that knife. Also, I wanna thank Kathy and Billy for being here on all these tapes. We do practice social distancing. I couldn't be doing these videos without them. Very hard to do this as a one-man show, and their dedication has always been the best. So I don't wanna forget in my appreciation for my Shihans and friends for helping me with this. So the next one now, he does get that grab on, and he goes and grabs me and looks to lunge that knife right into my belly. So what's gonna happen is we can't do what we call pouring, especially with a knife. Pouring means you can't reach for the knife because if you do, you're gonna get cut or you're gonna get slashed. So what happens here is the person goes and pulls us in. We do a bicep block to stop that knife from getting to us. And then we strike with a palm blow to bring that person's head back. We bring the person back down with a knee strike, and then we do a technique called the Hijimatikomi, which is basically an arm lock, arm bar, okay? We use some traditional names just to for the respect of some of my lineage, okay? So now the person's coming at us with the knife, they're pulling it, boom, there's the bicep block, there's the strike, he comes over the top. If he wants to, he can knee. If not, he can just snap that person's arm. Let's look at that one more time. Notice how he's not pouring. He's blocking the hand, so see the knife now has that separation so it can't get to us. Now from here, he slides the hand down, still having control of the knife, drives the person's face, comes over the top. If he chooses to, he can knee strike if he likes from here and then rip that person's arm off. You must understand that creating a system is kind of like life. okay? Kind of like everything that we've been going through and everything that we're dealing with, we're only learning to deal with it as it comes forward. You know, we never had something of this nature happen to us. So a lot of times people say, oh, nobody knows what they're doing. Absolutely true. Nobody does know what they're doing. So you're learning as we go along. Over 51 years of learning and developing American Jiu-Jitsu, this was not existing 50 years ago, but some law enforcement person, some person came to me and said to me, hey, what in this situation happens like this? Look at the closed quarters that are happening now with these marches and stuff, and some of them are turning violent. So, you know, a lot of people can say, well, a fight's gonna happen from over here. Well, not in a crowd, man. When that crowd's coming down your block and somebody starts grabbing you and somebody starts getting lethal with you, if you don't know what you're doing, close quarter combat, you're gonna end up dead. So that's where these situations have such value. So let's look at the gun. Now the gun. The gun typically reaction is the person gonna try to keep you away with that free hand because they have that projectile. So on the first gun technique, we're going to take that gun, we're gonna turn the person's body by how we move our hands, and then we're gonna pin the person's gun to their body because that's where it is, and then we're gonna do a technique that we learned all the way down at Blue Belt called the Kotogiyashi, and that's how we're gonna take this person down. So if the person goes to pour at us from here, he pins the hand from here, takes it right into a Kotogiyashi and bring it down. Let's go to the other angle on that one so they might be able to see that better, okay? So the hand is to the inside of the grip. He moves and sees, he's pinned it now. So as long as you have that projectile not facing you, you're safe. Now from here, he's gonna manipulate with a Kotogiyashi, bring that person's wrist down, have the gun pointed right at him and drive that gun right to the person's face. Again, a technique that's not easy to understand if you're not familiar with our system and our movement, it might look like it's too simple. That should be your biggest problem. When anything is done correctly, it always looks too simple. You ever paint your house? You probably made a mess. You ever watch a professional paint your house? Probably looks simple. That's why you tried to do it. So what I'm saying is everything looks easy when it's being done by people that have been doing it for over 25 years. All right. When you're watching this and people sometimes make comments in their brown belts or their blue belts, and I appreciate that. Listen, one day I was too, but 51 years later, I'm not. And our background and our history and our accomplishments are always verifying our techniques because we do use them in real life combinations, situations, and people that we train do. So please don't judge. Please, if you're interested, learn. And we're here to teach you, and we would love to do that. All right, so now the person's coming at us with a gun, but now our hands are a little higher, so we're gonna drop down on the palming hand, and we're gonna take this hand, again, pinning the hand to his body, and then we're gonna do a technique similar to what they call Kanoagyeshi. But as soon as we get to that Kanoagyeshi, we're gonna take the gun away. So watch this, as he comes at us, he drops down here, comes around, see a little better, comes down over the top, comes out and rips that gun right out, then positions himself just like so. Let's look at that one more time. Beautiful. All right, so being that she has a gun in the hand, let's look at the two gun techniques again, and then we'll do the knife technique here. Okay, all right. So let's look at the first one with the Kotogiyashi. Pins it from here, takes it, and Kotogiyashi. Okay, now the second one with the Kanoagyeshi takeaway. Over the top. Yeah, there you go. And rip it away. Beautiful. And now we have the two knife techniques. We're just doing a little review so you can watch this and review it on your own. All right, first one, the person's coming and reaching at us. We don't want to pour. We push the hand away. From here, get behind the person, reach him out, Harakatami. He has an arm bar and he has a neck lock. Okay, next one, the person goes to the lunge. Next one, the person grabs and lunge, boom, comes bang, hits from here, comes over the top, and there's your Iji Matsupomo. That technique or those techniques are called leverage hand from a knife or gun. It's when that person goes and grabs and either has a projectile or has a weapon that's going to lunge at you. I hope you get a chance to review these techniques, especially if you're going for that fourth degree level. If you're a new person, I hope you appreciate these techniques. Listen, our premise here was not to make instructional videos, was to give you contents so there's something more to do than nothing, okay? Or watching Netflix, although I do love Netflix myself. So that's really what it's all about. It's keeping you busy. Rumor has it that we might be reopening up on July 15th, phase 4. We have no concrete evidence, but that seems to be what they're gearing for. Our studio is ready. It's all 6-foot distancing. Our spin room is all plastic. Our front room is all sanitized and has all the plastic dropping too. So we have a bunch of things that are going to have to be followed. We'll keep you posted on that. Right now, stay home, stay healthy, stay safe. That's the main thing. Right now, if you're walking down the street and a lot of people come, probably the best thing you do is get in your car and drive away. You can't fight a crowd, okay? But I will tell you that self-defense is gonna be more on the perimeter for most people, because protecting yourself is a God-given right, and you have the right to do that. So everybody needs to learn how to protect themselves. If somebody crosses that line and tries to hurt you or your family, you're gonna know exactly how to protect yourself. So call us at American Jiu-Jitsu. Go to our website, AJJ Centers. Find out more about us. You'll wanna know more about us if somebody comes walking down your street. We're the right place to train. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great day. Thank you, Kathy and Billy, and we'll see you on the next tape. Have a great day.